जय श्री राधे,
फिर गोवर्धन में, फिर मानसी गंगा पे, गोवर्धन में, जय राधा कुंड में, जय श्याम कुंड में, जय राधे राधे, जय राधे राधे, हरि बोल।
वेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने
तस्मै श्री गुरवे वंशा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्णा प्रेम प्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरतिशे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तदालय कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तदभक्ताय यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेत कृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरह कातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मेतया तर्भोगिने तं सर्वभूतहृदयम् तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति पिज्ञै राधे तं नयमाम च भक्त्या विहीनाय पराधनस्य चेत्तास्य कामादितरं कृपामयि त्वं शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्दे नमस्ते
अब कैन आई रीड लाइक दिस I want that senior disciples of Swamiji, they may come forward. Oh, there are so many there. They can may come here. You should come nearer. My Bharat and all others. They should be here. Take your mridanga from there, anywhere keeping here. Yes. Navin should come in last and he will sit. Always a problem for Navin. Markandeya Prabhu, where Markandeya Prabhu? He has come? Has he come?
Yes.
Oh, you know that my English is very lame and poor. So sometimes I want to make any subject so much clear, but it may be that I could not make it clear. Yesterday in my class I told that we should try to hear Srimad Bhagavat from superiors. And if realized, then Rasik Vaishnava. Oh, very good. So everywhere in Srimad Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita, everywhere it is written, Ja Bhagavat Pada Vaishnava Rasthane. Perhaps you know all. Ja Bhagavat Pada Vaishnava Rasthane. What is the meaning? Pada. Pada means read. If you want to read Srimad Bhagavat, you should first go to any superior Rasik Vaishnava, and there you should hear and know how it is read. You should know the process. After hearing, then you can read and realize anything. Also it has been written, those who have no high class of association, they cannot take the meaning of Srimad Bhagavat. I know in India, from beginning to end, that all the Mayavadi sannyasi, high learned in Sanskrit, always talking and giving lectures in Sanskrit, knowing so many meanings of each word, it verbal roots everything. But why they become like Mayavadi? they cannot take off. They also explain Jiva Goswami and others, but they cannot take. That is why it has been told. It has told also that Aham Vedmi, Shankar is telling. Shankar means who Shankar? Mahadev, Vaishnavanang Jatha Sambho, Supreme Vaishnav, Adi Vaishnav, Shankar. He is telling, Aham Vedmi, I know the meaning of Srimad Bhagavatam. Sukho Vetti, and after that Sukh knows. And Vyaso Vetti na Vetti va. Whether Vyas know or not, there is some doubt. He has written Srimad Bhagavatam and he has seen in his tongues, but he is telling that whether he knows or not. Why? Actually, he knows half. How? Because he is in the line of Krishna, Shaktiman Tattva. He is not object of prem. But Shankar is the object of prem. Ashray. About of prem. He is in the line of Srimati Radhika. Sukhdev Goswami also, he was the parrot of Srimati Radhika. In the line of Radhika. So if anyone is the line of Radhika, he can know. Even Krishna cannot know. That is why he comes to know in the shape of form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And when he was initiated by Vishakha, and then he came to know all these things. In Gambhira he used to test. Then he was testing Srimad Bhagavatam, the mood of Radhika. Srimad Bhagavatam is nothing but the mood, internal mood, instance the mood of Radhika only, glorifying Radhika, not glorification of Krishna. Bande Nanda Brajaisthinang Padurinam Abhakshanar. So everywhere it has been told. So it is right that Vyaso Vetti na Vetti va, whether Vyas knows or not, there is some doubt. Also it has been told, if anyone not hearing so much, Sruto, Dhyayato, Anumodata, Vanumodata, if anyone is hearing Bhagavatam, if he is not, then he is is remembering some things. And if he cannot do, only his approach that, to hear Bhagavat is very good. Certifies only. Even a strong impression comes by that, like Sukriti, by this. If he is telling that, Bhagavat is very good thing. He is not hearing even, but he is certifying. Even something is coming. So it has been told that Bhaktya Vimochennara. What I told you in the morning. If anyone is. Yeah, wo shlok. Ki bolna? Shruto pashut. Na na. After this. If anyone. So if anyone is hearing from superiors with deep meanings, with so much bhakti, surrendering himself to Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavat is himself Krishna. So if anyone hearing with Shraddha, then if there is Shraddha, then Srimad Bhagavat words will come in your heart and will be realized. So these are the process of Srimad Bhagavatam hearing. But, श्रद्धान्वित अनुसृणीया तथ वर्णयेत जह भक्ति परांग भगवती प्रतलभ्य कामम हृदरोगणमाशु पिहनत चरण. So if anyone is sharing Srimad Bhagavatam in process and then reading with Shraddha, then all words will come and they will be realized itself. But if anyone has not so much association of high class of Vaishnava, what he will do? He should read shortly. There is no way. But surrendering yourself to Srimad Bhagavatam, Supathan, that is called Supathan. Supathan, Bicharan Paro, then you should think how deep the meaning is. Oh, words of Srimad Bhagavatam, you are transcendental. You should realize yourself, manifest your mercy in my heart, that I am kind. Realize. This is the process. I know so many high learned scholars of Swamiji, devotees, taken renounce and also remembering so many Srimad Bhagavatam slokas, from top to bottom to top, all slokas, and so many meanings. But when Swamiji departed from this world, they left all sannyas, reading Bhagavat and everything. So this is not process. If we want to go in deep in Srimad Bhagavatam, we must read. But if you are reading in process, it will help you. If you have luckily a association, and in association, any superior Vaishnava explaining Srimad Bhagavatam, we should not get lose that time. We should try to utilize that. And if no high class, we should read very gently in the guidance of such Vaishnava or such Guru. Not with false ego that, oh, you will understand Srimad Bhagavatam in that process. So you should read Bhagavatam. If no high class of association, you can read yourself also. But in this process, being very humble and offering yourself like Saranagati to Bhagavatam, then it will be realized. Then I told that, why 9th canto Bhagavat was told and after that Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto was told. We should try to be, make our platform to hear Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto. So we should know what is this world by the dialogue of Kapil Dev Devahuti that was told Shyamrani. You should realize that what is this world. What is this body? Only combination of stool, urine and so many bad things. By taking bath you cannot be purified yourself, because always full of all these things. So you cannot by taking snan. Only it can be by chanting name. If you have taken bath, amen. Just smaret pundik rikaksham sab bhaya bhyantare susu. Oh, they can be. So after taking bath, yet it has been told to do achman by the name of Krishna. But you are pure always, whether you are doing nothing or something. You are pure in heart, by soul, part and parcel of Krishna. So you can serve Krishna like Dhruva, no harm, but he was stopped. Where stopped? Because he has some worldly desire. Prahlad Maharaj has no desire. He was Mahabhagavat. We should try to make a basement like that, to hear if any problem may come, coming, so many problems. But Prahlad Maharaj was out of all these problems. Never disturb. If you will be like that, that you can remember chant Srimad Bhagavatam always. Otherwise you will be disturbed. To know all these things, you can read the chapter of Bharat Maharaj. Chitraketu Maharaj. You should know what is this world is. Don't so much attach to your children and wife and husband like Chitraketu Maharaj in his first life. They cannot make you happy. Never. So don't be worried. What you are, you should be like that, remembering, chanting Krishna. Anyhow, maintaining your life. What did Chitraketu in his last? What? He left everything. And he was given by Narad and Angira Rishi, the transcendental knowledge. So you should follow all these things. Then quickly I am coming to 10th canto. Parikshit Maharaj is telling that you have told me up to 9th canto, all things. But I am not yet satisfied. I am so hungry for this Harikatha. Nivrittatashai upagiyamanat bausadasatri manobhiramat ka uttam slok gunanubadat virajjait vina pasukna. Only very wretched animals who are like slaughters, they can avoid Harikatha from superiors. Like a speaker, Sukadeva Goswami. He has not touched even Maya from beginning of his birth. And then he was admitted in the school of Vyasadeva again. And he read Srimad Bhagavat from top, bottom to top. Everything. And especially he was a parrot of, very dear parrot of Srimati Radhika. Then he told everything in the court, in the council of Srila Parikshit Maharaj. So he is telling, Nivatta Tarasai Upagiyamana. If a speaker, having no worldly desires, no worldly problems, no attachment, like Sukadeva Goswami, or in his line. And he is explaining Srimad Bhagavatam. You should not lose that chance. It is for three kinds of devotees. Like those who want worldly desires to fulfill. Those who are mukt. Those who want liberation, and those who are liberated, and those who are bhakta, and those who are rasik. So for all kinds of the explanation of Srimad Bhagavatam from that class of speaker. Nivritta tarsai upagiyamanat. Upagiyamanat. What is the meaning of upagiyamanat? Not giyamanat. If he has heard from his guru, Rashik and Vaishnava, realized soul. And then he is speaking like Suta Goswami, Ugrasava. He attended the council of Sukadeva Goswami. He read Srimad Bhagavat from him. He heard, he was at the time of Parikshit Maharaj, that class was going. And he heard everything. And then Giyamanat, first Shramanam, and then if he is perfect, and then he is. Then it is a Vyarth Mahaushadhi of this world. Unfallible medicine. Unfallible? Infallible medicine. Or it will not go in vain. Those were in the council of Parikshit Maharaj and Sukhdev Goswami, all well reparated. All. Those who are junior, senior, Madhyam Adhikari, Kanishtha Adhikari, they all were improved to their stages. Those who were about to be liberated, they were liberated. Though I had no love and affection, they received that. So everyone there, they developed. So, what? Nivrittatashai upagiyamanat bausadat srotri mana bhiramat. What is the robe of this world? What is the main disease by which all diseases are coming? Only more diseases to forget Krishna. And this is called avidya. Ignorance. What ignorance? Ignorance of Krishna Tattva. Devotion and love. The ignorance of all these things is called avidya. So it also goes very quickly, very quickly. So if anyone is not listening with so great honor and strong belief, they are like butcher, killing themselves and killing others. So in this world, so many are butchers, not only one. So much are like butchers. And then he began. He told that, first he told that, I told so many reasons, 10 or more than that. First day I told the reasons why Krishna came. He appeared in the jail of Kansa by the womb of Devaki by Vasudeva Maharaj. And at the same time, he appeared like a baby connected with his mother Yashoda. Both are true. Both are true at the same point. Krishna appeared by Devaki as Chaturbhu, four-handed, long cut hairs, golden and jewels ornaments, at the age like 16, very young, very teenage age like, very beautiful. And in the same time, he came in the womb of Yashoda, and same time at 12 in night, he came from the womb of Yashoda, just like a baby, as baby comes, 200. And he was weeping like, kya, 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 like this. But you should know, Sukhdev Goswami has told that he was son of Vasudev Devaki. To whom? To whom he told? To all Mathura Vasis. He told all Mathura Vasis that Krishna is son of Devaki Vasudev. But when he is in Vrindavan, what he will tell? When he will come in Vrindavan, anyone of Vrindavan will not believe Sukhdev Goswami even that he is telling that he is son of Vasudeva Devaki. Never they will believe. Because they have seen already that Krishna came from the womb of Yashoda and he was some link at that time. And that link was cut down in front of them, in their presence. So how can they believe Sukhdev Goswami or anyone, or Akrur or Uddhav? They cannot. So if you are Mathura Vasi, then you can have this belief that Krishna is son of Devaki Vasudev, no harm for you. But if you want to be any Brajavasi, even a creeper, even a bird, even an animal of Vrindavan, then you will have to believe that Krishna is son of never of Devaki Vasudev. But both are true to their position. But it is more clear, and Sukadev Goswami has told so many times that, one thing more. The devotees of Mathura are high classes of devotion. They are devotion, high class of devotees. And devotees of Vrindavan also. No? But who are superior? Mathura Vasi, Uddhav Akrur, or Srimati Radhika, Lalita, Visakha, Jasoda, Nanda Baba? Who are superiors among them? Oh. Brajavasi. So we must obey what they are telling. We should have belief more than that. Sometimes Mathura Vasi tell so much lie things. So Krishna has also told that Mathura Vasi are always liar. That is why in Gita Krishna has told to Arjun that you should promise that I cannot give up any my devotee. If I am telling that, it may be that I may change. But if you will do, because I am Mathura Vasi, who was fighting in Mahabharata, he was not Brajendranandan. He was Vasudev Krishna. So he admits that all Mathura Vasi tells lies. So they are telling that Krishna is son of Vasudeva Devaki, so they are glad it is not true so much. Somewhat there is. So if Jasoda Maya telling that you are my son, no doubt of this. So first you should believe this. Swami has told in his Srimad Bhagavat sometimes for beginners that Krishna was the son of Vasudev, but he was given to Nanda and Yashoda to only to support and nourish. He was like adopters, like Krishna was adopted son of Nanda and Yashoda. But it is not true. Not true. You should have a form. Try to be a Brajavasi. If you are hearing this, then try to be a Brajavasi. First thing is this. Then you can realize Srimad Bhagavat. This is the basis. Krishna, having so much opulences and all kinds of powers, especially six of opulence. And where in Nanda Baba house, Brajanandan, all opulences, all powers and everything there, more than Dwarka and Mathura, but it is covered with very sweet Madhurya. Only high class of devotees can realize all these things. So try to have a heart of Brajavasi. Those who are sleeping, they will not have all these things. Please try to be sit like this, not like this, otherwise you will sleep and you will miss my class. And then you will be Mathura Vasi, even not Dwarka Vasi, even not, you will be Vaikuntha Vasi. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Sometimes world of Maya will go away. And if you are not hearing with attention, then what will be? You are not hearing, then it may be the evils of all others will enter in your heart. And they will sleep there very easily. So don't do like that. First thing. Second, Vrajendra Nandan is so merciful. Oho Bakiyam Stanakalakutam Jighansaya Payadap Pasakti Levin Gatim Chatudhat Uchitang Tato Kangva Dayalum Sharanam. What is the meaning? Oh, Prem Prajan. From there, stand up and tell. What is the meaning? Oh, at once.
So, in this verse, Uddhavji is calling out, Aho Bakiyam Stanakala Kutam. Alas! We should surrender to Krishna. Who will not surrender to Krishna? Why? Because he's just so merciful. He's so very merciful. How merciful is Krishna? Putana, who was so wicked and came to Krishna with the intention of killing him, had smeared the poison, filled her breast full of poison, and she came there just to kill Krishna. And what did Krishna do? He did not see, oh, she has come to kill me. But rather he thought, oh, she has come to me like mother. Because Putana came there, oh my son, such a beautiful baby, please you come in my arms. And she took Krishna and gave Krishna her breast. So she came like mother. Seeing this, Krishna accepted
also this. Also she met Shringara and everything like mother.
Yes. She came so beautiful, more beautiful than the goddess of fortune. When Mother Yashoda saw her, she thought, she is so beautiful, she loves Krishna more than me. She should take care of Krishna. So she allowed Putana to come there in that beautiful form and take Krishna in her arms. And Krishna, not seeing her wicked intention, but seeing, oh, she has come like mother, then he very mercifully, causelessly mercifully, gave her a position like his nursemaid, like a mother in Goloka Vrindavan. So Uddhav is remembering this quality of Krishna and crying out, oh, who will not surrender to Krishna because he is so causelessly merciful?
He was about 2.5 years or 3 years in Gokul. And met so many past, very beautiful pastimes there. Once, Krishna sent a demon named Shakatasur to kill Krishna. He thought that I am so much intelligent, I will not go there having any form. I should go there in the form of air-like. And he entered in a pull of cord and he wanted to press Krishna and to
smash him.
But Krishna is not like a such boy. And playing, he touched from his nails and he was killed at once. What is this? If anyone is so learned, he has read Srimad Bhagavatam and all Vedas, Upanishads and everything, but he may be like a demon. If he is not serving Krishna in line of love and affection, you know, all the Mayavadis are all Shakatasur. And in their lines, all are Shakatasur. They know all these things. They are very qualified. They can make so many meanings of Srimad Bhagavatam. They read. And all are chant. But really, in the end, they will tell that. What they will tell? Oh, we are same Brahma. Same Brahma. So these are all Shakatasur. Krishna, by trick anyhow, he kills and purifies their hearts. So we should be careful for this. You know, Trinavarta, What is the meaning of Trinavart? Naveen, what is the essence of this pastime? Trinavart. अरे बोलो झट करे तब अगर समय मत नष्ट करो हम जल्दी से आना चाहते हैं
सो त्रिनावर्त होइन सकरासुर किल बाय कृष्णा
टू टेल एसेंस द टीचिंग्स
त्रिनावर्त मींस जस्ट लाइक टोर्नेडो व्हिच टेक सो मेनी डस्ट एंड ड्राई लीव्स सिमिलरली हु इन दिस वर्ल्ड are not doing bhajan Krishna. They take so many things from material world. They are like Trinavarta. Just like they, Krishna killed Trinavarta. Similarly, if we take shelter of Gurudev, then Gurudev can remove our ignorance.
What is that dhul and trina? That logic against bhakti. That logic all take against love and affection. They are arguments of Mayavad, Smartvad,
impersonalism,
and all these things. But Krishna can't go. See. So, we should not hear the logics of all demons. I know, at that time only few demons were in this world, at the time of Krishna. But nowadays, everywhere, lakhs and lakhs demons. By logic they will tell against bhakti. So we should be careful for this. After this, how we can control Krishna and bind Krishna in our heart? For this, Damodar Leela. Yashoda wanted to bind Krishna. Why? Oh, Krishna has done something bad. His nature is going to be a thief, and stealing butter and everything here and there. Have you taken? Oh, no, I have not taken. What is in your mouth? I want to see. And he, what he saw? All world, everything in his world. Lakhs and lakhs, Vishnu, Brahma, all are there. What he thought? He thought that, oh, perhaps I am in dream. Or a ghost has come and he is in Krishna's mouth. Or anything else. He could not decide. He took water and washed that whether I am in dream or reality. And then he saw nothing. Never thought that Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. But you know Devaki, Vasudeva and Arjun. Krishna showed universal form to them and they began to fold hands. Oh Krishna, Arjun is telling me, I have done so many offenses, I have told you friend, but really you are not friend. You are supreme of creators and creators to creators to creators. Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadi Radha Govinda Sarvakaran Karanam. So from future, I will not tell you friend. I married your sister. I become so. What? Not favorite. Huh? That I married your sister. I am not qualified that. Oh, I have told you so many things. Oh, bring my chariot and keep it in the middle of both armies. I will never do in future. Please excuse me. And after that, when Krishna took it in yourself, he disappeared that and then he sent Jogmaya and then oh friend, come on, come on, and we should try to fight with these armies. You know about two times for Devaki and Vasudev. They were thinking that Krishna is my son. But when they saw very easily Krishna jumped on the throne very high and took Kans very easily. He threw out and he jumped on him and killed him very easily. Not killed. He was killed himself. By jumping only Krishna jumped on him. He did nothing. Yes, they were there. All were there. He had brought that, you should see, I am killing your son.
Presence of your son.
Yes. Also, Nanda Baba was there. All the gopis were there. His father also was brought there. Ugrasena also, Akru and all others were there. He wanted to kill Krishna in the presence of all. That I am so. But quickly, Krishna, without any
effort,
easily, he jumped over him and he was dead. What to do if I am jumping and if he is dying, what I should do? I cannot. So, they were praying to Krishna. Krishna was on the feet of Devaki and Baldev was on the feet of Vasudev Maharaj. But they were, I know that who are you? You are himself Narayan Tattva. Then Krishna was weeping there. Baldev was weeping on the feet of Vasudev Maharaj. They sat on their laps, even they were doing like this. This is the place. And Yashoda, she saw all these things. But he never thought that Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. Never. This is the difference between Mathura and Vrindavan. So Yashoda is more superior than Mathura Vasis. After that, you know that in Gokul, when he was Yashoda mother or Titan Krishna. Krishna loves to their devotees and devotees also love to Krishna. If the devotees love to Krishna is more superior, then he may be Titan. Or controlled, otherwise not. How you can control him? If you are in the guidance of Yashoda mother, or Subal Sridham Madhumangal, or in the guidance of gopis, beloved gopis, especially in the guidance of gopis, those who are, they can tighten Krishna and control very easily. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to sprinkle this thing. Why Yashoda was not tightening Krishna? Why? Why she was not binding? There are two things. Only two fingers were there, less. All the ropes were knocked, joined together. And it became like 1 mile, 2 mile, even long. And Krishna, this waist, was only 12 finger only. And there was a golden chain given by Yashoda mother. It was not going so much bigger, wider. But it was not sufficient for one time even. Always two fingers. There are two things. The endeavor of bhaks to do bhakti this way. With our intelligence, with their efforts, if we are wanting to bind Krishna, we cannot have his darshan, his so much mercy. He cannot be controlled. And there is mercy of Krishna always on all. One is mercy of Krishna and one is our effort in devour. By only devour we cannot bind him. When we will be sharanagat, surrendered totally surrender, not like now we are surrendering. Oh, we will tell Gurudev, today I have surrendered to you. But lock and key is with me, only surrendered by words. This will not do. You will have to totally surrender. How to surrender? You can go to Arjun, you can go to Brajvasis, totally surrender. If you want to more qualified in surrendering, then go to Gopis. They will tell the process how to be surrendered. Then Krishna was thinking that if Mother Yashoda is tightening me, then how can I play with boys? Sridham Subal are waiting for me. Oh, all the cows are waiting. For what? They are pain in their odds. Orders. But they cannot give me milk to their children's calves. If Krishna will come, and then only they can give milk. So, if Yashoda Maiya binds me, then I cannot go. So, it will be better Yashoda Maiya should not bind me. And at once Yogamaya came and see this miracle that the vest was there and ropes were longer and longer, but not even one time. Yashoda Maiya was trying to bind him. But when he felt that, oh, from beginning of morning, and now it is 12. I cannot bind him. Then he took shelter of his Thakurji. Oh, Narayan, oh, Thakurji, if I am not binding my son, then all Brajarshi will laugh at me. So his face was changing. And tears were always running. And his joy in his eyes, come always, as if they will come out. And seeing this, Krishna saw that now he knows that I cannot bind. He has full belief. But he was sweating and he promised that I will bind till one day, two, three days, whole life, but I will not give up you. I must bind you. And but he was taking shelter of Narayan and weeping, tears were coming. So Krishna saw, at once became merciful. And when he became merciful, at once Yogamaya ran away from there. And very easily, by the rope of bending hair, he was tightened. So if we are following gopis or Nand Baba, Yashoda, Sridham Subal of Braja, we can tighten. But this love and affection should be of Ashraya Tattva. Ashraya Tattva, you know?
Abode of love.
Brajvasi are all abode of love and affection. So must we follow. After that, you know, the pastimes of that fruit seller, that lady. He had heard something from the persons who are going to Mathura and coming to Mathura from Vrindavan, from Gokul. They heard that a very beautiful child, the son of Nanda and Yashoda. Very, very beautiful, very charming. And she wanted to take darshan. She used to take some fruits in his basket and to go around the Nanda Bhavan. And telling, oh, fruit low, low fruit, fruit low, fruit low, fall low, fall low, fall low, like this. Like Indians, oh, there are so many fruit sellers in Mathura here and there, Vrindavan. So she used to do. But sometimes Krishna used to sleep, sometimes here and there. Oh, she could not give, could not have darshan of Krishna. At that time he was, it may be of 2 years. Sometimes he was in the lap of Yashoda and taking breast. So he had never chance to see Krishna. But he told that, today I will go and I will not return until I will have darshan. So make a fixed this object of life. We should try to make an object like this. And she made an object. And do or die like having this promise. She went there and basket was there full of fruits. And she was telling, follow, follow. And in the meantime she forgets. And then what? Govindalo, Govindalo, Damodarlo, Madhol, Govindadamo, Dharmadhe. Easiest way to see Krishna, what is? Naam Sankirtan. And he adopted that process. You know, gopis, when Krishna disappeared, and they were doing like this. So Krishna can come quickly. So she followed this process and began to chant like this. They are practiced not to touch with hand their baskets and easily go dancing here, but it will be on their head. So, till 12 from morning she was doing. At least she was tired and sat on the side of Nanda Bhavan. On the door. And she was thinking, how I should see Krishna? So Krishna, at last, he took some corn from wheat or anything, grains. He was quite naked, only some gold chains and some twinklings. Sometimes Krishna, from very sweet, he was so much charmed. So he took anyhow and he was coming, and in the meantime from here, only 2-3 grains were there. And he came to, with a very greedy eyes, seeing towards fruits. Yellow, fair, reddish, banana, mango, angur, kadamba, so many.
Chiku.
It may be. In Braj, everything is there. But this is not so yellow or sweet. Yes. So that's golden like colors, golden colors and all. Amarud it may be. And Krishna with the greedy eyes went and, oh, give me fruits. She looked towards Krishna and became charmed. Totally charmed. Then she told that, I may give you, if you tell me mother, and sit in my lap. Then a very big problem for Krishna. If anyone see that I'm sitting on her lap, and addressing her, then all will laugh. What to do? And quickly then he looked here and there. Is there any waiting? Witness or not? He saw that there is no witness here. And then very quickly, in a moment she sat on the lap of that fruit seller and told, oh mother, give me fruits. And then quickly, give me fruits. And then very happily she began to give. What you want? Oh, this, that. So she gave. And then Krishna I first came with in this position, and now who are in this position? And see, more. She gave 2, 3, 4, 5, and it was full love. And then Krishna, oh, looking and dancing, and went to his mother. And he gave all the fruits in the bell of his mother. Oh, from where you brought? And quickly he began to distribute. And hundreds of gopis were coming there and taking, but not finishing. No end of fruits. All became what?
Unlimited.
Very sweet, very sweet, very sweet. And what became of that fruit seller? He was thinking, he was sitting there, because his mind, his heart was taken by Krishna, stolen away, without heart. And she was so much upset. After some time, anyone came and, oh, why are you here? What you are doing? Anyhow, he remembered something and took his basket. And he started to go his home at Mathura, in the maid way, when Jamuna was there flowing. Oh, he saw that, felt that, oh, this is why it is so heavy, heavy. Then he took it up and down, and he saw that it was full of jewels, diamonds and so many things. Then he became wondered. Again she took it on his head and fell into Jamuna. All these things, no need at all. And what became, anyone does not know. She became totally mad in the eyes of the world. Do you know what became? Oh, she became more than Devahuti. Whether his bell was there, she was naked or what she was. Always in trance. She became more than that. And Krishna, at once it may be that Krishna has taken his outer shell, this, and quickly given more thing than Putana. And sent at once to Golok Vrindavan to serve. Krishna is so kind. Can you be like this? Those who have shown no relation with Krishna, his bhakti is what? Shant, like Shant. No special relation with Krishna. No special relation. But thinking like some, like mother, he told his heart like a mother. But Krishna gave him more superior than Putana. Also more than Kubja and others. So Krishna is so merciful. Try to realize all these things quickly. If your bhakti is so high, oh, in one birth you can have like this. And you will have to come to this position. Yes. Oh, yes, that Putana went to Golok, but she went to Vrindavan, more superior than that. And then Krishna came to Vrindavan, and after Vrindavan he did so many things. First he killed Dhenukasur with Baldev Prabhu killed. What is this? The essence of this story? Who will tell? Oh, you can tell? Then Kasur? Quickly. In a 4 lines.
Dainikasura was the donkey demon friend of Kamsa. And actually, they thought that this forest belonged to Kamsa. And they were guarding it so that no Brijbasis could come there. And a donkey works very hard for another master, and he never enjoys anything himself. And he tries to enjoy sex life with his wife, who always kicks him in the face with her hind legs. So that's the mentality of a donkey. So these Dainikasura demons were like that. But Krishna's friends wanted to enjoy the fruits, so Krishna took them there, and Krishna and Balaram killed all the demons. Balaram is the Adi Guru, and he kills all the demons of ignorance. So he killed Dainikasura by swinging him around by his hind legs and threw him up on the tall tree. And then Krishna and Balaram killed the rest of the demons. And those who weren't killed ran away in fear. And then the boys were able to enjoy the fruits.
Oh, Dankas has so many things. First of all, they are ignorant, quite too ignorant. Secondly, oh, they are so much lusty. Always bitten by the hind legs of sea donkeys, but never
giving up.
Always running. And so much ignorant. Who can save you from this? Only Gurudev, Baladev Prabhu. You should always know that all gurus who are qualified and bona fide, they are manifestation of Baladev Prabhu. All are prakash of Nityananda Prabhu or Baladev Prabhu. Oh, they don't realize this, they are not qualified guru. They cannot save from these donkeys. So, Nityananda Prabhu and Baladev Prabhu both, same thing. Nityananda Prabhu most merciful. As Mahaprabhu is more merciful than Krishna, Nityananda Prabhu is more merciful than Baladev. Those they are same. No difference at all. But some difference of their mercies. So if we are taking shelter, a guru in the line of Nityananda Prabhu, Baladev Prabhu, they can save from this. Very, very, very hard to become out of lust. Krishna has created in all species, what? Some ladies and some male and female. It is very rare, very hard to come out of this. Especially Hrida Rog, it is called Hrida Rog. You can give up your children's and wealth, reputation, everything. Very hard to give up the idea of the mood of self-praise. And more hard, this thing. Or in heart it is. So only Baladev Prabhu can do this. So Baladev Prabhu quickly killed that demon. But we are saying that so many brahmachari worshipping for 20 years, engaged by Swamiji, and when he departed from this world, oh, they came again, they married here, there, become lusty. Even the sannyasis, serving and worshipping deities, or reading Bhagavatam, preaching Soman, but this lust came, and controlled, and they were driven from this devotion line. So you should try to be. This is not the first time in this that you have taken the shape of human and you are married. This is not first. I think this is lakhs and lakhs time more than that you are with these things. When you will realize this fact, at once you will be like Sukadeva Goswami, Mahaprabhu, Raghunath Das Goswami. You will have to come in this process if you want to go there. Today or after some days, you will have to be like that. Even you are in marriage life, you will have to be like Pandavas, like Srinivasa Acharya, like others, like gopis and gopis. You will have to be. All were attached with Krishna, not with anything. So these are essence of instructions we should try to follow. Then, the pastime of Brahma, he saw that Agasur has been liberated and he makes in the toes of Krishna. But actually, he was liberated and it seems that he mixed in Krishna. But not, he cannot mix. Like Jai Vijay, in the shape of Shishupal Dandapakra, they were liberated and they mixed in the Krishna body. But actually they became Jaya and Vijaya. And then with Narayan, when his pastimes was finished, completed, then they went with Narayan. So it seems that they were liberated, mixing in Krishna, but Brahma was anyhow looking after this. And he became very happy. Oh, Krishna is so merciful. And he has appeared like a boy and he is doing all these sweet pastimes. I want to see some pastimes, more pastimes. So I should do anything that I can see. If he has prayed, then it was process. But he never prayed. He did something. What? He was discovering anyway that I should do something that Krishna should play. He thought that I should stole away all the cowherd boys and all the calves. At that time he was grazing cowherd calves. So he thought. But from where this thought came?
The influence of Yoga Maya.
Oh. Krishna wished at that time, oh, I want that lakhs and lakhs gopis want that I should be their son and they should give me, keep me in their laps and give me their best. So they want all. I will help to fulfill because I have made a promise like this, Je jathang mam prapadyante tam tathavubhayam. So I must be their son. Also, lakhs and lakhs cows. The cows of Nanda Baba, 8 lakh. 9 lakh. And the cows of Vrishabhanu Maharaj, 12 lakh. And others, lakhs, uncounted number. They wanted that Krishna should be our cows. Oh, Krishna is desiratory. He also wanted that I should be cow of all the cows. And in Vrindavan, in Gokul, in everywhere, Nandagaon, everywhere. All the young girls, oh, they wanted that Krishna should be our husband, like our beloved. All wanted. So Krishna has to fulfill his hours. So Krishna thought that, oh, it's a good time. At once he sent the Yogamaya. Nothing to send, always Yogamaya in him. She knew, and at once manage this. And Brahma stole away the cowherd boys and calves and he kept in a cave. And for a moment he went to his abode and quickly he returned and for this world it was like 1 year. And what happened? When he returned, before this, Baldev Prabhu was still. Oh, very strange thing. At first, I used to see that all the gopis were having so much love and affection for Krishna more than their children, their sons. But now I am seeing that equal love for Krishna and their sons. And also for cows I am seeing. Oh, they have so much affection for their older son than why? What is the thing? And then he saw, oh, very wonderful Krishna. He began to laugh, smile, and told Krishna, oh, Krishna, what is this? I'm seeing that you are cough salts. So your stomach was not fulfilled by taking only the milk of Srimati Yashoda, your mother. So you became lakhs and lakhs cowherd boys. Even not fulfilled, then you became all calves here. And what is this? All the cowherd boys like you yourself, not older one, original. Why? Oh, to marry with all gopis. You have married men, all by all gopis. At that time, the priest of Gargacharya told that this year is very good year and auspicious. you should give marriage to your all daughters, even those who are in womb of you, their mothers. Even you should. To make friendship, that if a son will be in from your woman and my daughter, or my son your daughter, then we will marry. We should have a promise like this. So all gopis were married. Only not Radhika. There was some trick of Yogamaya. At that year she was not married. Oh, for Radhika, for Vrishbhanu Maharaj, it was a very bad year. So this he should not do. So trickly. So all the gopis who were married that year were married to Krishna. And also Srimati Yashoda was married to Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu is the Radharani. Oh, he was not married, but his manifestation was married to Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu, who is he? He is also manifestation of Krishna. So shadow was married to shadow. Radha was not. Because Radha is only power of Krishna. She cannot be divided with Krishna. One with Krishna. For pastimes she becomes like this. Otherwise, only one, both are in the shape of Mahaprabhu. And when they are in two, they become Radha and Krishna. But even one soul, two bodies. By pure devotion, you can realize these things. So we should know all these things. So what was I telling? Brahma Mohan. And then this is the essence of the Brahma Mohan Leela. This is essence. So in one ek kajate kare bahuka.
Krishna can accomplish so many
tasks by your one action. In one action. So Krishna was doing like this. Then, you know, that all the gopis were like Sitaji, golden Sita, and all the Ved mantra of Dandakaranya, all the girls of Jodhyapuri and Janakpuri. And so many Jyothaki, Ajyothaki. They came in Vrindavan. And for them, that what? Katyayani Vrat was there. They were observing Katyayani Vrat for 1 month. But who came in the last? Why Katyayani could not come? If they were worshipping Katyayani, Katyayani should have come. But she never came. Who came? Krishna himself came. And he gave benediction to them. Those will be like gopis. If Krishna wants, you should give up all these things. For happiness of Krishna, we can give up all these things. This body is also like a garment. You know that Devahuti and others, Sukadeva Goswami had no need to cover these things. Nothing. We are ignorant, that is why we are doing so like that. You will have to be so much above. For Krishna, nothing to give. Everything he should give. Then we can come in that. Now, very quickly, we will come in Raslila, and then I will come to my object of telling Harikatha here, beginning from Kamsabadha. How Krishna came from Vrindavan? Why he came? All wants to be in a place where love and affection is so much. We know all that in Vrindavan, love to Krishna and affection is so superior. Not Mathura. Mathura is also there something. But not like... But why Krishna left? And if he left, he should have come time to time to meet with them. But he never came. Why? He wanted to console gopis. Why he did not come himself directly and console? He sent his one messenger. Huh? Why he sent? Oh, one thing is that Krishna is so having so much affluence and he is so powerful. Why she could not, he could not invite all the gopis and Nanda Baba Yashoda to Mathura or to Dwarka? If he can take all jadas from Mathura to in one night at once, why he cannot bring all the gopis, Nanda Baba Yashoda and cows and everything there, and he can live with them? Why? There is a scarcity of place in Dwarka because it's surrounded by ocean, so there is no place. Is it the fact? Oh, there's so much place. But why gopis and Nand Baba could not reach there? These are the questions we will try to solve tomorrow in my class, and then we will go Gaur Praman.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. A couple of short announcements before the drama starts. One is there will be initiations on Saturday morning at 8 o'clock. So anyone who would like to come forward could meet with Naveen Krishna Prabhu or Brajanath Prabhu and get that opportunity to speak with them regarding that. Also, there's many new people here. I want to thank all those who have come forward and registered for the festival. So any other new devotees who've come or any who have not done that yet, could please come forward and meet with myself or Nirgun or Nilachala Prabhus. Also, Mahibharata Prabhu, is he here?
Yeah.
He had one announcement that he has tapes from this year from Hawaii and Los Angeles and New Braja. So if anyone would like to get tapes made, he can make copies of everything. So if you bring them to him, then he can do that. Mahi, can you stand up so they can see who you are? Hare Krishna. Haribo. He'll also be in many dramas, so you'll recognize him. Anyway, for tonight, this is a drama about the... Also, there's a few song books that were missing. They were in the garage on the other side of the house. If someone maybe was just looking at them, if they could kindly bring them back. Can you show what they look like?
Yeah, two of them are missing and they've been paid for. Please, if anybody has them, return them.
So please return them to Mother Bichitra, or Bichitra Didi, excuse me. So tonight, this drama is the reasons for the advent of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And this drama was performed in Maui, Hawaii, and it was very captivating. The devotees there loved it so much, and especially Srila Gurudev loved this drama so much he asked it to be performed here. Again, in New Braj, he's been speaking so much about the different reasons, especially the internal reasons for the advent of Lord Chaitanya. So, and he asked for this to be performed and for more to be added and for it to become more fine. So I think we'll all appreciate it here even more. So thank you very much, and here they are. Hare Krishna.
Arising forth from the womb of Srimati Sachi Devi,
as the moon appears from the ocean, in the Sangha of my Premi Bhaktas, I shall dance and loudly sing, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. I will bestow the topmost prem and highest ras unto even the lowest of jeeves. However, Devi, aho, the greatest thing is that I will not reserve this prem only for my bhaktas or even the human beings. However, I shall give it to one and all, the animals, the trees, the creepers, the grass, even the very ground that I walk on will be drowned in Krishna prem. I shall take my own holy abode of Shweta Dweep from Golok Dham. I will bring it to this earth. It will be called Sri Navadweep Dham. Dasarath and Nandababa shall be known as Jagannath Mishra, my father. Kaushalya Devi and Yashoda Maya, they will be Sachi Devi, my affectionate mother. I will be known as Sri Sachi Nandana Gora Hari. And you, my dear Sita, you will be my beloved wife, Sri Vishnu Priya.
How wonderful, my lord. Another opportunity for me to say...
Allow me say, Devi, there is one more thing, something very Gambhir. At the tender age of 24, I must leave you and take sannyas.
Sannyas? No! No!
You will be a Choti Sikhi Sori, a tiny, teeny-aged girl, only 16, so soft, so sweet. Yet I will have to leave you and go to Jagannath Puri. Not being able to bear my separation, Devi, you will faint in the affectionate arms of my weeping mother.
No. Why will you leave your mother? Why will you leave me? What will be the happiness that you so much...
Devi, I want to weave a web of prem that nobody can escape from. However, some will try to escape from this web. Therefore, I shall devise a trick. I will take sannyas, and those who have previously offended me will be forced to pranam my feet. And with only one pranam, they will gain the adhikar by which they will also attain to my highest mercy, O Maharani. However, there is a much more confidential reason for my taking sannyas. O Devi, shall I tell you what it is?
Please, my lord, batao.
Baby Maharani, Aye, listen to me as I tell you the secrets of love. My devotees relish prem for me in two ways. When they are with me, they experience the joy of sambhog. But in my separation, they feel vipralamba. Naturally, my devotees always want to be with me, but I mercifully bestow upon them vipralamba ras. Why? Because, Devi, the more intense and deep the separation, the more intense and deep the joy of union will be. And, Maharani, when my devotee is drowning in the ocean of separation, she forgets all external consciousness, even her own body. At that time, I appear before her, Shakshat Darshan, and I bestow upon her in ecstasy millions of times greater than she has previously known. This, Maharani, is my direct mercy. Suniye Priye, soon you will have to go to the forest. You will live under the care of Valmiki Rishi. I will stay at home in the Rajbhavan. Not being able to bear your separation, Maharani, I will make a golden murti of you. Day and night I will weep, Hasite, Minasita Kotai. Suniye Devi, in reciprocation, in a future incarnation, I will go to the forest and you will stay at home, making a golden murti of me. Then, day and night, with tears falling from your eyes, you will cry out, Hanimai, Amar Nimai Kotai. And in this way, my dear Sita, you also will experience that very same intense vipralamba.
Before the advent of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the devotees of Navadvip used to gather in the house of Advaita Acharya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudiraya Nasta Preshu Badreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtaki. We are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 1, Text Number 10. Prayen alpa yusha shobhya kalo asmin yuge janaha manda sumanda matayo manda bhagya hi upadrutaha. O learned one, in this iron age of Kali, men have but short lives. They are quarrelsome, lazy, misguided, unlucky, and above all, always disturbed. Om Aganat Marandasya Gana Gana Shalakaya Chakshun Minitam Jaina Tasme Sri Gurube Namaha Panchakalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bevacha Patitanam Pavane Bhyo Vaishnave Bhyo Namaha. The people of this age are very lazy, not only materially, but especially in the matter of self-realization. This human form of life is meant for self-realization. That is to say, man should come to know what is the self, what is the world, what is the super-self. In this age, people are victims not only of many political parties and creeds, but also of many sense-gratificatory pursuits. Unscrupulous men invent their own religious systems which are not based on any revealed scriptures, and people who are addicted to sense gratification are attracted to such institutions.
So the purpose of our life is to fulfill all our material and religious duties?
No. Just as by watering the root of the tree, all the leaves and the branches become satisfied, in the same way, by offering one's worship and love and devotion to Sri Krishna, the beloved of all souls, all the living entities are benefited. Sarva dharma an prachaja, mame kam saranam vraja. Ahang tvang sarva pape bhyo mokshyasyami masuchaha. Abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender unto me. I shall protect you from all previous reactions. Do not fear, Sri Krishna has said. Everyone is engaged in material enjoyment, either sinful or virtuous. No one is interested in the transcendental service of the Lord, who can grant total relief from the cycle of birth and death. If only the Lord would appear as an incarnation, he himself could grant devotion by his own personal example. I shall worship him in a purified state of mind. I shall constantly petition him with humility, not being able to repay the debt to one who offers him a tulsi leaf and Ganges water. Sri Krishna liquidates the debt by offering his very self to the devotee. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Oh, Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna. 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 Krishna.
Krishna.
Krishna.
Made all the residents of this world
other forms. You are not bewildered. Why does this Brahman bewilder you? Why do you say, who is he?
After speaking these words to his beloved, the smiling lover Krishna touched his Kaustubha jewel. The jewel, understanding the Lord's intent, glowed and then showed all the same pastimes and all the moving and non-moving entities she saw in her dream.
Relishes and to experience the pleasure she feels when she realizes the sweetness of my love. I will appear in the womb of Srimati Sachi Devi, endowed with the mood of Radharani, just as the moon appears from the ocean. I will personally inaugurate the religion for the age, the congregational chanting of the holy names. I shall make the world dance in ecstasy, realizing the four mellows of devotional service. I shall accept the role of a devotee and teach by my own example. Simply by following the regulative principles mentioned in the scriptures, one cannot attain the loving sentiments of the devotees of Braj. By hearing about the pure love of the inhabitants of Braj, devotees will worship me on the path of spontaneous love, abandoning all rituals of religiosity and fruitive activity. Thus, I will spread kirtan even amongst the most degraded, and I will weave a wreath of the holy name and praying and garland the entire material. And I will call out to everyone, please come into my fold, come into my fold.
Hari Haraye Nama Krishna Yadavaye Nama Yadavaye Madhumaye Keshavaye Nama Om Gopal Govinda Ram Srimadishwadam Sri Hari Gopinath Madanamohan Chaitanya Nityananda Sri Advaita Gopta Hari Guru Vaishnava Bhagavata Gita Jaya Rupa Sanatana Bhakta Raghuna Sri Jiva Gopal Bhakta Dasa Raghuna Gosai Kori Charana Bandhan Jaha Hoite Vignana Yavishta
Puran
O Ichaya Gosai Jara Muita Radas Ashavara Padare Numor Panchagas Tadera Charana Sevi Bhakta Sangeva Janame janame mori abhilash Bhaye chay gosai jabe baje kulabash Bhaje Radha Krishna nitya lila kori na prakar Bhale nanande bala hari bhaja vrindavan Shri Guru Vaishnava pade majai amon Mone Anande Vala Hari Bhaja Vrindavan Ishi Ghato Vamsi Vata Dada Satanan Mone Anande Vala Hari Bhaja Vrindavan Shyam Kunda Radha Kunda Giri Govardhan Mone Anande Vala Hari Bhaja Vrindavan Lalita Vishakhaya Dijata Shatigan Mone Anande Vala Hari Bhaja Vrindavan Sudam Sudam Damba Sudam Jata Shakhagan Mone Anande Vala Hari Bhaja Vrindavan Madhur Madhur Vamsi Vaje Yaito Vrindavan Mone Anande Vala Hari Bhaja Vrindavan
Anande Vala Hari Bhaja Vrindavan
Guru Vaishnava Pade Majai Amar.
Shri Guru Vaishnava Pade Majai Amar.
Shri Guru Vaishnava Pade Padma Kaliya.
Shri Guru Vaishnava Pade Padma Kaliya.
Nama Sankirtana Kare Naratamodar. Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda. Shiva Shadi Guru Bhaktavinda. Bala Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Ramo Ramo Hare Hare.
Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare.
Hare
Hare Ramo Hare Ramo 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 Hare Hare. Bala Krishna Krishna Hare Hare. Ramo Ramo Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare Hare.
Blessings to the players. Very high class of course. I question generally to devotees who are so sincere and senior devotees, but they cannot reply. What are the three desires of Krishna? That he became Sachinanda. If you can realize this thing, what are the three desires, then you can know the glory of Srimati Radhika, the glories of Gopi, and the process which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu descended to give. That route Goswami has given in his books, to follow books. If you are not understanding these things given in Chaitanya Charitamrita, the main cause of coming Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Sri Sachinanda Gaur. These are very secret, also very high. You should try to know all this from devotees, high class of devotees. Then you can understand. Otherwise you cannot. I think the devotees, like if she played my darling daughter Tumbidya and Shamapriya and Chandrika, Haripriya, Chandrika, oh, so qualified. I saw, I admire to Advaita Acharya. Very good play.
He's come all the way from Hawaii.
Yes. So my heartly blessings to him. My heartly more blessings to these qualified girls. I want they should preach very boldly my all these things, teaching to whole world. And you should also try to understand these three desires and be qualified. What was the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Then you can think the glory, you can touch the glory of Swamiji, otherwise not. Not, never you cannot. A mind like this, he can glorify Swamiji. Other people think that, oh, he was very opulence, having so much, oh, he has cut the jungle of Mayavad, oh, with so many arguments, goat, what? Logics, and will be confined to that. Oh, he has really come to give these things to world, to sprinkle the mercy of gopi prem. What was that manjari prem? This was the object of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Rag marga pravartan. Because why? Because he was supreme merciful. Hey, chup chup, baitho. Baitho. Sit down. Otherwise I will twist your ears. I know the trick also. So, what? Go.